أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم Dear viewers السلام عليكم auditing MCQs part 7 کے ساتھ آپ کے خدمت میں حاضر ہوں most important 20 MCQs کے یہ ویڈیو شروع سے لے کر آخر تک دیکھنے کی کوشش کریں let's start question number 121 ہے auditing seeks option A conclusive evidence option B carburative evidence option C both A and B option D persuasive evidence dear viewers auditing seeks option D is correct auditing seeks persuasive evidence next investigation seeks option A conclusive evidence option B corroborative evidence option C both A and B option D persuasive evidence option C is correct dear viewers investigation seeks conclusive evidence and corroborative evidence next audit is conducted by option A cost accountant option B company secretary option C chartered accountant option D any person dear viewers audit is conducted by chartered accountant option C is correct next investigation is conducted by option A cost accountant option B company secretary option C chartered accountant option D any person option D is correct dear viewers investigation is conducted by any person next investigations implies systematic critical and special examination of a records of business for option A journal purpose option B unspecified purpose option C specific purpose option D none of these option C is correct specific purpose dear viewers investigation is made for specific purpose next the purpose of audit and investigation is option A same option B different option C sometimes same and sometimes different option D none of the above option B is correct different dear viewers the purpose of audit and investigation is different next one of the following is not an advantage of audit option A it provides satisfaction for owner option B it helps in getting loans option C it reduces cost burden option D it detect error and frauds dear viewers option C is correct it reduces cost burden this is not an advantage of audit dear viewers baki jo teen hai option A option B and option D ye audit ke advantage hain next primary responsibility for the adequacy of financial statement disclosures rest with the option A auditor option B management option C auditor staff option D central government option B is correct management dear viewers primary responsibility for the adequacy of financial statement disclosures rest with the management next which of the following is not the objective of internal audit option A to keep proper control over business activities option B to evaluate accounting system option C to report to the owners and outsiders option D to evaluate the internal check system dear viewers option C is correct to report to the owners and outsider this is not an objective of internal audit next the investigation is related to critical checking of option A internal record option B particular record option C accounting records option D all of the above option B is correct particular records investigation is related to critical checking of particular records next the audit opinion is based on the information provided by option A employees option B government option C management option D all of the above option C is correct management dear viewers audit opinion is based on the information provided by management next An audit cannot add exactness and certainty to financial statement when these factors, option A, don't exist, option B, exist, option C, are not known, option D, none of the above. Option A is correct, don't exist. Next, the evidence obtained by an auditor are persuasive rather than, option A, correct, option B, reliable, option C, conclusive, option D, all of the above. Option C is correct, conclusive. Dear viewers, the evidence obtained by an auditor are persuasive rather than conclusive. Next, generally, an auditor needs to release the report up to, option A, a specified timeline, option B, unspecified timeline, option C, infinite timeline, option D, end of the accounting period. Option A is correct, a specified timeline. Dear viewers, auditor needs to release the report up to a specified timeline. Next, money can be borrowed easily on the basis of audit balance sheet from, option A, private sources, option B, creditors, option C, financial institutions, option D, government. Option C is correct. Dear viewers, money can be borrowed on the basis of audit balance sheet from the financial institutions. Next, an audit helps in protecting the internet interest of, option A, employees, option B, government, option C, management, option D, shareholders in case of joint stock company. There is option D is correct. An audit helps in protecting the interest of shareholders. Next, auditing is very useful in obtaining the independent opinion of the auditor about, option A, financial condition, option B, business condition, option C, profit losses, option D, none of the above. Option B is correct, business condition. Next, no one will try to commit an error or fraud as the accounts are subject to, option A, scrutiny, option B, internal control, option C, audit, option D, none of the above. Option C is correct, audit. Next, the auditor has to compare the balance sheet and profit and loss account or other statement with the, option A, bank statement, option B, cash book, option C, both A and B above, option D, books of accounts and sporting vouchers. Option D is correct, books of accounts and sporting vouchers. Next, the compliance test and substantive procedure performed by the auditor will determine the effectiveness of, option A, management accounting system, option B, cost accounting system, option C, internal audit system, option D, internal control system. Option D is correct, internal control system. Dear viewers, please like this video and subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching.